important consequence of these observations was that religion has become a voluntary activity, a matter of choice. The general drift away from religion is reflected by the growing importance of Jewish culture in the past decades. Being Jewish today means, in a large extent, the identification with Jewish culture, while religion is still an option on the menu. Many authors who are discussing the subject of identity argue that Jewishness is replacing Judaism, and the sources of Jewishness is something much wider than religious tradition or ethno-national identification. This is not to say that religion is excluded from this composite, but Judaism has become a matter of choice, and not only the preservation of tradition in the first place, but also the particular elements of this tradition. So there are two different factors, what I wanted to point at. The first one is a general change in the way to construct Jewish identity, and the second one is a local factor, which is characteristic for the Jewish population we investigated. Consequently, the societal definition of who is considered a Jew is also changing. While ethnic and halakhic definitions remain relevant in many communities, more and more people are willing to be less strict. A large number of Jews are prepared to accept others as Jews if they so identify themselves. But the clear reflection is, well, if you put all this together, then these results reflect the fact that after the collapse of the communist system, the so-called Jewish question became a political issue again, playing a central role in the political struggles and in certain countries in the old context, with the anti-Semites on the right and the anti-anti-Semites on the left. And this influences much more the choice of political values among the Jews than their relation to the Jewish tradition. So this was more or less, but if you have any questions later, we can discuss that.